been a while since we've had a game like that. And I thought the girls went out, they executed the game plan, everything we worked on in practice, they executed today in the game. So, you know, I was really proud. We kept turnovers down, we contested shots, we rebounded, and if we can keep that going, this team's going to be able to, you know, win a few more ball games.
Defensively, I'm guessing you were fairly pleased. I mean, they shot 18.9 for the game, 10% in the third quarter. When you, I mean, you really played good defense, I thought, that first half of the second or the third quarter.
Yeah.
It just looks like the light bulb is coming on brighter.
Yeah, I mean, we played for a complete game, and that's what Mesa basketball is all about, and just suffocating teams. And that's what I was really excited about tonight. They just did a phenomenal job. And we've got to keep that going, though. You know, games are going to get tougher, and, you know, some are going to be closer, and the girls just got to be able to go out there and compete. And I thought our concentration was really on point tonight. But to hold them, you know, to 5 points in the second, 6 in the third, and 8 in the fourth, like I said, it's been a long time since that's happened. But when they do that, we've talked about doing it once. Let's say, hey, let's get one quarter where it's 10 and less, and they did it 3 tonight. So I was really proud of them.
It was hard for you guys to keep the concentration once the lead kept going. Did you just kind of try to forget about the scoreboard and just go play?
That was actually the main theme in a lot of our timeouts and talks, was to keep playing hard and keep our foot on the gas pedal, because they weren't going to let up, and we needed to keep going and play like a complete game, like Coach said. So, yeah.
He took you out for, what, a minute and a half in the third quarter. It was the first time I think you've been on the bench in a couple of weeks. Did you almost get lost trying to figure out how to sit down for a few minutes?
No.
I mean, how were you able to just keep playing at a high level the last 3 weeks or the last 3 games, playing pretty much every single minute?
I just think it comes down to what we do in practice and conditioning-wise. And I think it's a mental game, too. I think if you tell yourself you're tired, you're probably tired. And if you tell yourself you're not, then you're not. So I think that's all that has to do with it. I think my teammates helped me out a lot. I think just a breather here and there with, you know, whether it's free throws or them encouraging me keeps me going. So, yeah.
Jamisyn, I thought you probably played your most complete game this season. And can you just tell, is there a difference between before and after Christmas with you? Is everything making a little more sense now?
Yeah, I've kind of just realized that it's a completely different game from high school, and so I can't score as much as I used to or create as much as I used to, and so I'm just kind of doing the things I can control and just figuring it out as I go.
Yeah, and that's kind of, you know, we were talking to some, you know, some Olivia. The freshmen usually can take that first year and kind of learn a little bit, and you guys haven't had that luxury, so you kind of learn something every single day if you're on the floor.
Yeah.
And I mean, I know it probably gets frustrating at times, but how have you guys kind of been able to fight through that and kind of get going again?
I feel like, especially with our coaching staff and our teammates, like, we have such great examples and just someone to push us every single day. And it's just every day we learn something new, and every day we have more goals that we can push towards. So once we hit a goal, we finally, we have more goals to achieve. So it's just every day is something to work for.
Yeah. Coach, I know you said, you know, that they ran the game plan. I mean, you know, they bring the 6'3 kid in. You bring Monica out, so it brings her away from the basket, and it really opened up the game inside, and open up everything outside, and, you know, the kids are learning, it looks like, to kind of figure out these wrinkles you're going to throw in.
Yeah, and Monica creates a problem because she can play inside, and then, you know, she can get out a little bit on the perimeter, and, you know, with some of the bigger girls that don't move as well laterally, you know, she's able to take advantage with that, so we like to use her sometimes in those situations.
Yeah, you know, it's not like you've never played a post player on the perimeter, right?
Never.
Yeah. I mean, you know, you play 5 out, yeah, you know, a lot of times.
Yeah, I mean, we really like people to be able to do everything and be a threat. And so, you know, and that's one of Monica's strengths. She's one of the better 3-point shooters on our team. And so we've got to utilize that before she graduates. Get her a few more.
Do it while you've got
yeah.
them. You know, obviously you got a couple of kids healthy or healthier and got them in. You know, got Brooke, you know, a minute or two, and you know, you're starting to build maybe some depth for down the road. And obviously, it's not a bad thing to get some kids back.
No, I mean, you know, that's the thing is it's a long season and. Seemed like a lot of our stuff happened early on, and you know, we still have quite a few that won't make it back this year, but you know, to be able to add a couple more here at the home stretch, and if everyone else can stay healthy, you got to have a lot of luck to win it. You know, you got to stay healthy, and hopefully you know, we get the healthy bug here in the next couple weeks, and we can kind of finish out the season and you know, make a run at this.
Can you kind of see the difference from the first couple of weeks to now in this team? And I mean, you're a quote unquote veteran because you played last year. And can you kind of see everybody getting on the same page, it looks like now?
Yeah, you can see it, but you can also feel it. And it's not just in games, it's in practice and off the court as well. It just feels like you know what your teammates are going to do and what you're going to do with them. And it's, I don't know, it's nice. Easier, I guess.
Yeah, and you know the tradition of this program, and I know you're trying to help the kids who are actually younger than you kind of learn it as you go, and you know, it's kind of a process with this program. But how much is it helping, especially the young kids, Jamisyn, about you don't have class right now, you can just get in the gym, you can hang out together a little bit more, not that you know you weren't before, but how much does this break kind of help you guys with basketball?
It's a great reset, honestly. Like, all we're doing is focusing on basketball, and we're all here because we love basketball, and so it's just a few weeks full of what we love, I guess. And so we're constantly in the gym. We're constantly with each other. Like, it's helped so much, and I feel like we've grown just especially over these past few weeks as a team right now, and so I feel like this break is really good for us.
So it's hard to look at a game like this and take many negatives away from it. But I'm sure, Coach, you know how it is. You can nitpick some things here and there. What can you take from tonight's game to kind of bring a little bit even more into tomorrow night's game against Colorado Christian?
Yeah, I mean, it's a totally different game. So we're going to have to do some different things better. You know, our rebounding's got to really pick up. And I feel like Colorado Christian's probably a better three-point shooting team. And so we've just got to be more disciplined. So what we did, we just have to do at a higher level tomorrow.
All right, perfect.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thanks, guys. Thanks. 10 seconds to 10.